All of the astronauts, both within Canada and the other partner agencies such as NASA, have been undergoing geology training for many years. And there's a couple of reasons for that. One is, when you're on the International Space Station, you're always looking back upon our own planet. And so astronauts looking out the window sometimes pick out areas of interest. So understanding a little bit about what the geologist might be looking at helps us take better photographs. The other side to geology training is the fact that we're gearing up to go beyond low Earth orbit again. And anytime we go to the moon or an asteroid or eventually Mars, geology is going to be an important part of the science that we do on those surfaces, both to understand the history of our own planet and the solar system, but also to understand resources that we might utilize on the surfaces of those planetary bodies. So I've spent a lot of time learning geology both at NASA, the Johnson Space Center, and recently in Canada. I've had the opportunity over the past two summers to go on expeditions into Saskatchewan and the high Arctic on Victoria Island to investigate craters. So right now I'm gearing up to go to the Arctic again. This time it'll be Devon Island in the Canadian Arctic with Dr. Osinski. And this will be a different experience for me because Dr. Osinski has been to this crater before. He already has done research. And now what we'll be looking at is going back and having a closer look at some of the areas that he has an interest in, questions that have come up since he looked at the samples he collected and did some more rigorous research into what formed the crater on Devon Island. And so I'll get to accompany him as we follow up on his research on Devon Island.